Yo, Chuck, bust the move, man. I was on my way up here to the studio, you know what I'm saying? And this brother stopped me and asked me, yo, what's up with that brother Chucky D? He's way nice. I said, yo, the brother don't swear he nice. He knows he's nice, you know what I'm saying? So, Chuck, I got a feeling you're turning into a public enemy, man. Now, remember that line you was kicking at me on the way out to L.A. Loud and Queens while we was in the car on our way to the shop? Well, yo, right now, kick the bass for them brothers and let them know what goes on.
Yeah, Coach, we're going to wrap this interview up, and I appreciate your time for coming in order to complete what is the first known Warrior TV inaugural session. But I want to leave on this. I want to ask you one more question. Ultimately, in looking at the talent level that we have in the Metoka area, what is your goal, let's say, over the next 4 years? Where do you see the baseball team going?
Well, I think anyone who's ever been in this community, in this area, it's something special about it. Sometimes you can't really put your finger on it, but this is a very unique community. It's everyone here is hardworking, full of grit. They like to get after it. They like to, they want to do what's best for their area, their community. I want to build the program back to where it was when I left. I want to get back to where you have to think about Metoka every time you go to play. You know, we're there. We're going to look the part. We're definitely going to get after it on the field. I think most people know I teach a pretty aggressive style of baseball, so I can say I have a football background too, so I like to take that aggression onto the baseball field. We have some really great young talent coming up. The kids won the BIF tournament a couple years ago. All those kids should be coming to the high school now. We have the foundation of what the seniors of last year brought. Those guys really stepped up leadership-wise. A lot of people told me that, this player's not going to be able to do this, this player's not going to be able to do that. I don't really deal with it not being able to do anything. We're going to talk about the things we can do. And those guys, I think, have laid the foundation to build that base back up quicker than most people could imagine, because those guys really started to buy into our philosophy, really embraced the Warrior way. Casey Willingham and Troy and Lucas and Brandon and Chase and Bryce and Marcus, those guys really embraced it to the point where these younger guys have now, they have to pick up and carry that legacy. We give an award every year called the Warrior Pride Award. It means a lot to me. It's named after Coach Leek, who coached here for so long. And we have the Warrior way that you have to follow. And last year, I knew I wanted to give the award again. We still have the baseball the kids have signed, from Brad Franciscus to Brandon Porter to Brandon Allen. So we have all these guys on there that embody what it means to be a Warrior. And so last year we gave it to the class of 2020 because the way they handled themselves with the virus and losing their senior season, not a single student in that group said it's about them. They start talking about the program and the foundation of building the program back. And I think our guys now will pick it up and run with it. Tanner Clements and Ryan Fahey and Cornell Island, David Field, a lot of guys within the program, I think they're going to step up and take it to other levels. I wouldn't be surprised to watch these guys compete for a title somewhere down the road. I think they have the ability, and I think they can do it. And obviously, I'm gonna push them to as hard as I can to build the program back and bring back that Warrior pride that we all have. And I wouldn't be surprised if you're not reading about a lot of kids going to college to play ball for these next 4 or 5 years and long into the future. So. I look for big things from the Warriors, and I know we're going to look good too, because we're gonna make sure that you look the way you play. So we're gonna look the part when you see us on the field. Everything's gonna be running pretty tight. And I can't wait to see what these guys do in the future. I'm as big of a fan as I'm a coach. So.
And Coach, I'm going to also brag on you with this point. We did a little research during your tenure as the Metoka baseball coach. We have it at about 45 players during your time as coach that were able to move on and play on the next level. Is that number about correct?
Yeah, that's 45. That's pretty accurate, Coach.
Yeah, for anybody that wants to say that Metoka players don't get into school to play, continue their careers, you know, I'm going to make sure that with every sport we highlight, let them know our coaches are working very hard. You know, of course, not everyone can play on that college level. But again, we want to try to push as many as we can to reach their potential. If that's their goal, to play on the college level, again, that's an amazing number because there's so much talent out there. But 45 Warriors able to go and play on the next level is an amazing number. And I just want to say thank you for that. Sometimes we wait too late to give people their flowers. I'm going to give you your flowers now and say thank you for all that you've done for Metoka High School as a teacher, as a mentor, as a coach, as a great colleague. I think that, you know, you're an outstanding person. And so we're going to wrap this interview up. So everybody, again, Coach Fred Stoops, you know, what a wonderful, wonderful asset that we have in our Metoka community. I want to thank everybody for tuning in. We will be having more videos coming up. There may be a Fred Stoops part two coming in, coming up down the line. But again, we want to say thank you to all of our Warrior fans out there. Thank you for watching. And I want to say it loud, Warrior proud. Peace.